In this problem, we're going to do a shell balance to analyze the mass transfer to a catalyst sphere. And what we're going to assume here is that the reaction rate at the surface of the sphere is very fast relative to diffusion. And so the reaction rate to produce our product B is completely controlled by the diffusion process. Right, and this is a phenomenon that you might observe, for example, at high temperature, where mass transfer is often the limiting factor in controlling the reaction rate. Okay, to solve this problem, we're going to do a mole balance through a spherical shell. And I've drawn just a little section of the shell within our gas film that surrounds the catalyst layer. All right, that gas film has a thickness of delta. And we draw a little differential element inside that I don't draw all the way around just because I wouldn't be able to draw a very good shell. All right, but it's a very thin slice inside our spherical region that we're going to do our material balance through. Okay, we can write the material balance into the shell as being the flux in the radial direction at 4 pi r squared. And we can evaluate that at point r. And then we can subtract out the flux at the other end of the shell, which will have the same form. But that will be at an r plus delta r. And what we're interested in doing here is making the shell infinitesimally thin. And so we will look at the limit as delta r approaches 0. I should set this equal to 0 because we're assuming steady state operation. And so we have an n minus out equals 0 when we divide through by 4 pi delta r and then take the limit as delta r approaches 0, then the result that we get is the following based on the definition of a derivative. This is our simple mole balance for this system. And to work with this, we're going to need to use a relationship that helps us describe what the flux is and how it relates to parameters that we can measure. And we'll use Fick's law in this case to consider the equimolar counter diffusion of A with respect to B. And Fick's law says that the flux will be equal to negative of a diffusivity times dCa dr. And now what we'll simply do is plug Fick's law for our diffusion process into the boxed equation above. Okay, and so this differential equation describes how the concentration will vary in the radial direction. To solve this differential equation, we just need some boundary conditions. And so the first boundary condition is that at the outer surface of the film, the concentration of A is equal to the bulk concentration, which is CA naught. Our second boundary condition is that at the surface of the catalyst sphere, the concentration of A is equal to zero because the reaction is very fast, and so as soon as A reaches the surface, it is reacted away to form B. And so now we can integrate our second order differential equation with these two boundary conditions to solve for how the concentration of A varies with position. If we integrate once, we get that r squared dCa dr is equal to an integration constant, which we'll solve for in just a minute with the boundary conditions. We can then divide through both sides of this equation by r squared, and then integrate this first order differential equation. And that brings in a second integration constant, C2. We now use our boundary conditions to plug in for values of CA at known values of R. All right, so 0 is equal to negative C1 over capital R plus C2. Use boundary condition 1 for the outer boundary condition at R plus delta. This gives us two equations and two unknowns, where our unknowns are C1 and C2. And so we just have to solve for those, and I won't go through the details of that simple algebra. And just I'll write down the results for C1 and C2. And there as follows. And so now we have an expression for the concentration of A with respect to CA naught, R, and delta, capital R and delta. And we can write that out this way by just plugging in the integration constants and dividing through by CA naught. Okay, and we see that the ratio of CA to CA naught varies between 1 and 0, depending on whether we're at a radial distance of capital R all the way up to R plus delta. So it goes from 0 to 1. Over that extreme, so that is a sanity check to make sure that we've applied the boundary conditions in an appropriate way. All right, and this describes a region where R, lowercase r, is always greater than capital R. This number will always be less than 1. Okay, and this is our result, part of the way there to determine our final answer, but this shows how the concentration changes with position inside our boundary layer. All right, we need to solve for the rate at which B is produced with time. All right, and so we, again, are going to have A that's diffusing through this diffusion layer, and it arrives at the surface of the catalyst. And so the rate at which it arrives at the surface of the catalyst determines the rate at which B is produced. And so we just need to evaluate the rate at which A arrives at the surface of the catalyst. And to do that, we just write that the total rate of production, which I'm going to call a W, total rate of production of B, is equal to the flux of A times the cross-sectional area through which that flux goes, evaluated at R is equal to capital R, so evaluated at the surface of the sphere. From our differential equation for Fick's law, we see that we can relate that flux N sub A to concentration. We'll just use Fick's law here, which I'll rewrite at this point, and take the derivative of the expression in the box that's two lines above, and that will allow us to solve for N sub A, for the flux of A. We then plug that expression for the flux of A into our expression for W that we want to solve for, and collect some terms, and we end up with the following expression. Okay, and this expression makes some intuitive sense, that as the radius of the catalyst sphere increases, that we have more opportunity for reaction and a higher reaction rate. As the bulk concentration of A increases, we have more A molecules that can react and therefore a higher reaction rate. And then you can also see in this expression that as delta increases, so as the thickness of the film across which we have to have diffusion increases, that the rate of production of B will actually decrease. And so all of this makes sense. And the final part of the question asks what parameters we need to know in order to solve for the rate of reaction of B. And so we need to know the radius of the catalyst sphere, capital R. We need to know the bulk concentration of A, CA naught. And then the trickiest thing that we need to know is the value of delta, the thickness of the layer through which A has to diffuse. All right, and this is more difficult to measure experimentally and is usually determined by a fit to experimental data.